Mosquitoes spread multiple diseases, killing 750,000 people each year. Dengue is the fastest growing mosquito-borne disease on Earth, as reported cases climb to over 3.2 million per year.
Dengue was one of the most painful illnesses I've ever had. There's a real reason why it's called breakbone fever in a lot of different languages, because it truly feels like your bones are breaking.
In the last 50 years, mosquitoes have spread the chikungunya virus across the globe.
The word chikungunya originates from East Africa, and chikungunya literally means shriveled up. So literally your hands get into a cramp, your bones, everything gets into a cramp. People walk bent forward like this.
Much more lethal than chikungunya is the West Nile virus. Infection can lead to inflammation of the brain.
I had West Nile virus. The very beginning was the darkest because it was so frightening and I was so ill. The dreams, the visual disturbances were frightening. Rapid short-term memory loss.
Like West Nile, the symptoms of malaria can begin with fever, aches, and nausea. It can quickly become life-threatening.
I've seen far too many children dying of malaria. Kids that are in a small little clinic with convulsions, with a high fever, getting into a coma because of cerebral malaria. It has a lasting impact.
Malaria targets the liver, stopping the flow of blood to vital organs, killing one child every 2 minutes.
If you start adding up malaria and dengue and chikungunya and yellow fever and West Nile, I mean, these diseases have major impact worldwide.
In fact, in rich countries, there's almost a naivete about these things. People are surprised if you have infectious disease coming into an area.
If a really harmful disease ends up in a population that is completely non-immune, have no immunity whatsoever, the virus will spread like wildfire. I mean, we've already seen chikungunya in France. We've seen a big outbreak of dengue in Portugal. We've seen dengue in the Eastern Balkans. We've seen West Nile in Greece. We've seen the Usutu virus in Vienna. So it's the one after the other African virus that is popping up in Europe. 20 years ago, nobody could have thought of this, and now it's there.
I love mosquitoes for their evolution, for the insights they give us into the sort of deeper meaning of life itself and our relationship with the planet. But I absolutely hate what they do to humanity in terms of serving as vectors for diseases. About 3,500 different species of mosquitoes have actually been classified. But really only a very, very tiny number in terms of species and in terms of diversity are actually responsible for spreading diseases.
Aedes albopictus, also known as the Asian tiger for its ferocious bite. The Culex genus, one of the most common mosquitoes on Earth. Anopheles, strictly feeds on humans, and his bite is considered the deadliest in the animal kingdom. And Aedes aegypti, a people-loving urban dweller, the species most associated with the latest Zika outbreak. Mosquitoes, like humans, are one of the most successful species on Earth. Only females bite, seeking our blood to provide protein for their eggs and ensure their own survival.
Mosquitoes are actually extremely capable of sniffing us up. They respond to compounds that come from our skin, and they respond to exhaled carbon dioxide. She will respond to a moving object. There's also body heat that will trigger her. And she can actually land without you feeling it. As soon as she's done that, then in her mouthpart, she's got two stylets. And these stylets, they basically look like two bread knives. And these bread knives rip open your skin. And then the proboscis, which is a central tube, will actually go right in the middle of that. Once she's underneath your skin, she will then, with these two bread knives, cut your small little capillaries that are passing your blood.
When a mosquito bites a human carrying a virus, she becomes infected through the blood meal, and the virus replicates in her cells. She carries infectious saliva. And when she lands on her next victim, she has one more trick that makes her an extremely efficient transmitter of disease.
What the mosquito does in order to prevent the clotting of the blood, she injects her spit. And by spitting in her saliva, that's how the virus is actually being introduced into the system. So all of the trouble that we have with mosquitoes worldwide is all because of mosquito spit. That's what it is.
For all of our advances, our ingenuity, our technology, we are increasingly at risk to infectious disease. We've been fighting sickness for centuries, but today a disease can spread around the world much faster than we could ever have imagined.
We got malaria coming across from Africa. Then we got yellow fever coming across from Africa. And then we got dengue coming across. It took around 3 centuries for these 3 diseases to make it from Africa across the Atlantic Ocean to the Americas. In the last 16 years, 3 more have been added to that list. West Nile virus, chikungunya virus, and Zika. 16 years for 3 diseases, 300 years for the 3 diseases that preceded it.